In this video, we'll be discussing the popliteal artery. It's the continuation of the femoral artery as it passes through the adductor hiatus, which is this space just here, made up by the tendons of the adductor magnus muscle. The popliteal then moves inferolaterally to lie between the two femoral condyles. This space we call the intercondylar fossa. I'm going to highlight that on the left knee just to make it super clear for you. Now, we also refer to this diamond-shaped area here as the popliteal fossa, the borders of which are made up by nearby muscles. So when it's passing through these spaces, you can see the popliteal artery passes pretty close to the knee capsule, which is this fibrous enclosure for the knee joint just here. If we continue inferiorly now, it moves between the two heads of the gastrocnemius muscle, which we're going to make transparent, so that we can see how the popliteal artery eventually terminates by bifurcation into the anterior and posterior tibial arteries. So some of the blood which is passing through the popliteal artery then goes on to supply the calf and the foot. But primarily, when we think of the popliteal artery, we think of arterial supply to the knee joint. And indeed, the five branches of the popliteal artery all contribute to this periarticular anastomosis, which you can see here. Now, before we crack on with naming these vessels, we'll get something important out of the way. Let's talk about the word genicula. It's derived from the Latin genu, which means knee. So genicula just means of the knee. And when I say superior lateral genicular artery, essentially what I'm saying is the superior lateral artery of the knee. And that is the first branch that we'll cover, the superior lateral genicular artery, which courses around the femoral epicondyle here to supply the superior patella, which is this bone here, as well as some of the bone and synovium nearby. Synovium being the jelly-like connective tissue which lines our articular surfaces. The superior lateral genicula anastomoses with the descending branch of the lateral femoral circumflex artery, which we spoke about in the video on the femoral artery. So that's the superior lateral genicula there. On the other side of the knee, we have the superior medial genicular artery, which anastomoses with the descending genicular branch from the femoral artery. It supplies the same structures as the superior lateral genicula, just on the opposite side of the knee. We then have the middle genicular artery, which begins in the intercondylar fossa. It penetrates the posterior joint capsule and supplies the posterior cruciate ligament, or PCL, as well as the posterior section of the anterior cruciate ligament, or ACL, and the posterior menisci. We'll have a closer look at all of these in a second. The inferior lateral genicular artery next curves around the lateral tibia, apply the lateral collateral ligament, as well as the anterior ACL and the inferior patella. Then the inferior medial genicular artery does the same on the other side. So that's the medial collateral ligament there. It supplies that, as well as the anterior ACL and the inferior patella. So we'll remove the patella now to better appreciate the joint of the knee, the intrinsic features of the knee joint. The inferior medial and lateral genicula supply the anterior ACL and the anterior menisci. The middle genicula supplies the PCL, part of the ACL, and the posterior menisci. The superior medial and lateral genicula supply the superior patella and the bone and synovium over which they pass. Now, the last branch of the popliteal are the sural arteries, which supply gastrocnemius, which we brought in earlier, as well as the soleus muscle and plantaris. These are all supplied by the sural arteries. And that is it for the popliteal artery. Thanks so much for watching. Hit subscribe if you like this video, and we'll see you next time.